Out of 7 billion, 1.25 billion is the Indian population. And out of 1.25 billion, how many are chartered accountants? Just 2,40,000. That makes it all the more highly competitive, respectable, and you are aspiring to join this elite class of professionals. And it will not come easily. That also we are aware of. But you have the potential to be part of it and enjoy that privilege and respect from the society, isn't it? And how many are the women students and women chartered accountants? From 1949 to 1999, 50 years, 8% of the total population of chartered accountants comprised of women. That means 92% male chartered accountants. Today, it is 21% women chartered accountants, 79% male chartered accountants. What was achieved over a period of 50 years, 8%. Now, from then, less than 14 years, another 13% has been added, 21%. Among the student population, 35% are girl students. While parliament is talking about 1/3, we have surpassed quietly girl students. And Pattabhiram was talking about the olden days when men were working and women were homemakers, housewives. 20 years ago, smallest decision, if you asked an housewife, she would have said, I need to consult my husband. Today, every husband is telling the same thing. I need to consult my wife. Olden saying goes, behind every successful man, there is a woman. They started asking, which woman? So they clarified, behind every successful man, there is a wife. Afterwards, they found out that women are becoming more and more successful in the last 2 decades. So the saying had to be modified. Behind every successful person, there is a spouse, and remove the gender bias. So that when women are successful, men also get credit for not stopping them to grow. And the modern tax saying is, behind every successful person, there is a spouse and the income tax department. One takes the credit, the other takes the cash when they come for such and seizure. So this is how the story goes. Now the point is, even after you accomplish, qualify and enter the corporate world, the journey has to be, you know, quite challenging and satisfying. Accomplishment should always be the driving force for you. Once in a while, even if not for your occupational requirement, on your own also, as I said, traveling place, meeting people is an education. So you have to be going outdoors, mix with your peers. Even now as student, when you attend students' conference, the exchange of thoughts, ideas, you get immensely benefited. And even in classroom, when you meet students from different offices, background and all that, always have a sport of your choice, because that makes life all the more interesting. Qualify, you will become an elite class. But even otherwise, considering the population of India, where very few can afford to pursue higher education, the enrollment ratio itself is very poor in India, in the schools, in primary schools. And many of them don't go to secondary school, don't go to high school. Then the question of college or higher education. So you are among the selected few. You have to be grateful to this society and your parents. Continue to be in good company, always thinking big, give your best and conquer greater heights. Now you can, for achieving all this, you can select a positive role model. Try to excel, because let me tell you, there are so many records set by so many sports personalities. Every record is meant to be broken. You have to surpass your role model, and it is not difficult at all. It is possible. So you have to believe in that. Here you look at the competence and character matrix. Taking too much time to elaborate, because it's obvious, I will only elaborate on that one quadrant which talks about stars. See, high competence and high character. is what is required. What should be your goal? Because by sheer hard work, competence, you can reach the top. But unless you have integrity, you cannot stay there. The fall could be mightier. So don't get carried away by temptations or greed. Mahatma Gandhi said, there is enough for everybody's need, but not for the greed. And it is not the end alone should be good or noble. Even the means by which you want to achieve it should be good and noble. So shortcut methods may take you to greater prosperity, but that will not be cherishable. That will not be admirable. See, as students of commerce, I am sure you will appreciate it if it is put in a different perspective. There are tangibles and intangibles. Give more emphasis on intangibles, less for tangibles. Even corporates which are concerned more about the turnover, top line, earnings per share, fixed assets, net worth, so on and so forth, giving more emphasis on tangibles may not become the best. But corporates which give emphasis to intangibles like goodwill, brand value, customer satisfaction, quality control of the product, human resource development of the organization, all these intangibles may or may not get captured in the balance sheet. These intangibles, if you are able to secure within you, the goodwill, the brand image, tangibles will automatically follow. You know, if you are very keen on tangibles, maybe you will belong to a class of chartered accountants who is chasing 5 companies for a job to be selected by one of them. So if you give importance to intangibles and maintain your reputation, maybe 5 companies will chase you to be recruited or retained or engaged in different capacities. And the choice is very obvious, which one you want to belong to. You should always continue the habit of reading. Inculcate the habit of reading. There are a few versions of books that are available in the market, which will regenerate you, which will infuse you with values and good thoughts. Like this Robin Sharma, he has put in simple ideas. Not that any of them are new, but the way he has put it, it will inspire you. And Dragon and Elephant is the story about China and India, so where we are trying to position. And Freedom at Midnight. I used to address in the Middle East every year on Indian budget. And I used to meet a lot of my erstwhile students settled there overseas. I have also had the privilege of meeting the rulers of some of those countries and regulators who have all said our economy is built largely by the contribution of Indian chartered accountants. That gives immense pride. And some of those Indian chartered accountants who have been my students, when they privately converse with me, they used to share their guilt. I used to ask, you know, you are well settled here, you're doing fine, why you have this feeling of guilt? They used to say, no, whatever I may be accomplishing, I am not within India. So I used to tell them, it is not necessary that you should be within India, but it is necessary that India should be within you. And whatever you do, whatever you accomplish, the credit will come to India because an Indian has done it. Indian has contributed it. So that's what I am telling you also. I mean, open your wings, spread your horizons, expand your vision by reading such books. This picture, I just want to narrate a small story. There was a young boy by name Howard Kelly. He used to be doing the supply of goods and newspapers on a door-to-door basis, gather money and support his education, self-sustaining model. Lot of struggle, and one fine day, for him, bad day, he was starving. He did not have money even to get him a meal. He did not know what to do, and he had no energy to go ahead with his daily routine. So he knocked the door of an house, desperately wanting to ask for some food. But when the door opened and that lady was smiling at him, he did not have the courage to ask for food. He felt ashamed. He simply asked for a glass of water. But that lady looking at his face with absolute exhausted and tired, she brought a glass full of milk and gave it to him with all the affection. So this boy drinks it, gets regenerated for the day and starts working again. This gave him a lot of reassurance that there are still good people in this world. He studies, works hard and becomes a very famous physician and establishes his own hospital in one city. As time passes by, a lady gets admitted into the hospital. So he goes and sees the lady. He instructs the hospital head that when the bill has to be prepared, route it through me. The treatment gets over, the bill gets prepared and it is sent to Dr. Howard Kelly, who writes on that bill, paid in full with one glass of milk. See, 20-25 years we learned. Next 20-25 years we earned. But the accomplishment comes only by sharing what you have learned and what you have earned with those who are in need of it. You owe this as a matter of gratitude. I mean, he was fortunate to repay to the same lady who showed kindness to him. All of us will not get that opportunity. We will get benefits from some. We should pass it on to someone else. That's how the journey has to go on. Let me tell you, my dear young friends, Padma Shri Award by itself did not give me any happiness. But independent of that, whether at all it brought me happiness subsequently, the answer is yes. For two reasons, it brought me happiness. One is, I found that the profession was celebrating the conferment of Padma Shri on me. So I thought this is not an award given to T.N. Manoharan. It is an award given to the profession of chartered accountancy, which is celebrated by the profession. Therefore, I also felt happy about it. Second reason, my 85-year-old mother was in Rashtrapati Bhavan, standing up and applauding for her son. And my 95-year-old father, who was not having a vision, was listening to the TV commentary of my name being called and my walking ahead and my sisters and brothers explaining to him every moment of mine till I received the award. These two thoughts, this visualization dominated my thinking and I felt happy. That only brought the, not the award, but the joy the parents got brought me the happiness. What I'm trying to say is, whatever you accomplish, the real accomplishment is the day when you make your parents feel proud of yourself and your accomplishment. And they will be really happy only when you accomplish whatever you are accomplishing, not at the cost of values, not at the cost of your health, and not at the cost of happiness. By preserving values, preserving your health and happiness, if you accomplish, that will give them tremendous joy. And program of this nature, what we have done, it may not create a future for you, but it will mold you for the future. It will certainly shape you for the future so that you are in a position to handle the challenges and accomplish what you want to accomplish. Patabram was talking about what is going to be the 21st century, the knowledge. So you are going to be knowledge-based professionals, finance professionals. You will dominate the future. 18th and 19th century belong to Europe. 20th century belong to US. 21st century must belong to India, and all of you must make it happen. I have no doubt that you will make it happen, and I wish you all the very best. May God bless you with success and bright future. I hope to see the day when all of you will become colleagues of mine and Patabiram in the profession of chartered accountancy as members of ICI. God bless you. All the very best.